Amen. 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 Am almost half a year.
Maybe
I've done something wrong.
Amen.
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 But I thank God that I'm here.
Hallelujah.
It is not by might nor by power.
Yes.
It's all by the grace of God.
Amen.
In the name of the
Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. I'm so happy to see you this year.
Amen.
I believe that God is going to bless us
this
year.
Amen.
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 He's been blessing us throughout the years.
Amen.
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 He will continue to bless us.
Amen.
Because he who started the good work in us is able to finish it.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Our God is able to finish it.
Amen.
Does not do half job.
Yes.
He does a complete job. All the time.
At
all times.
No.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Can we go straight to the word of God? The book of Luke chapter 2. And Philippians chapter 2. Amen.
Hallelujah.
I believe you are happy to be here.
Amen.
Amen.
Don't worry, I'm not going to be too long. I know some of you going to school. Some are going to work. So we'll try to be short. And then I believe if I be short, then I will get another invite very soon.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
All right.
The book of St. Luke chapter 2. I will take it from verse. Let's take it from verse 41 to verse 52. Yes. Now his parents went to Jerusalem every year at the feast of the Passover. And when he was 12 years old, they went up to Jerusalem after the custom of the feast. And when they had fulfilled the days, as they returned, the child Jesus tarried behind in Jerusalem. And Joseph and his mother knew not of it, but they, supposing him to have been in the company, went a day's journey, and they sought him among their kinfolk and their acquaintance. And when they found him not, they returned back again to Jerusalem, seeking him. And it came to pass that after 3 days they found him in the temple, sitting in the midst of the doctors, both hearing them and asking them questions. And all that heard him were astonished at his understanding and answers. And when they saw him, they were amazed. And his mother said unto him, Son, why hast thou thus dealt with us? Behold, thy father and I have sought thee sorrowing. And he said unto them, how is it that ye sought me? Wist ye not that I must be about my father's business? And they understood not the saying which he spake unto them. And he went down with them and came to Nazareth, and was subject unto them, but his mother kept all these sayings in her heart. And Jesus increased in wisdom and stature, and in favor with God and man.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Okay, proceed.
Batswadi ba gagwe e be ba go ya Jerusalem mo nyaneng wa Pasika ka ngwaga. He setse ile ngwaga e le somi le metso e mebedi ba rotogela Jerusalem ka mokgwa wa monyane. Yare ba ge ba feditse matšatši ao a ona ba boa ngwana Jesu a šala batswadi ba gagwe ba sa tsebe. Ge ba nagana ba re o na le ba ba sebedišanago nabo basepela leto la matsatsi ba monyaka go metswalo le go ba ba tsebanago nao ba mothoka ba buisa ba boela Jerusalema ba fela ba monyaka gwa fetsa matsatsi a mararo ya ba gona ba mo fetsa go ntle go kgethwa a dutse gare ga barutsi a ba tsietsa a ba botsisa ba ba mokwago botlhe ba kgotsa tlhalogano ya gagwe le diphetolo tsa gagwe ge ba mmona moo ba tlabega mmagwe a re ngwanaka o reng o re dira tse o go bone tatago le nna re go nyakile ka botlhoko yena a fetola a re lebe le reng le nnyaka ka lebe le sa tsebe ge ke tshwanetse goba go tee tsa tate ledileo a leboletse goba seke ba di fosisa gomme ba fologa le bona gomme a fologa le bona a ya Nazareta a dula ele e a ba kwago mmagwe ditaba tse ka moka a dula a di bolokile pelong ya gagwe Jesu a tswelela pele a tlhalefa a ya le mengwaga a kgatlha modimo le batho
Philippians chapter 2 verse 5
Philippi 2:5
Let this mind be in you which was also in Christ Jesus.
Kgopolo e tshwanetse go ba mo go lena ke e e bego e le go Kereste Jesu.
Amen. Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, we come before thy holy throne of grace and mercy in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Dear God, we invite thy Holy Spirit in this place.
Amen.
We say, Father, may you send down your Holy Spirit. And may your Holy Spirit move from heart to heart, my dear God.
Amen.
May you bless every child of God that is in this place. May you bless them, Father, in a very, very special way.
Amen.
Mighty gracious Father, may you please hide me behind the cross.
Amen.
Hide my brother behind the cross.
Amen.
As we'll be ministering together to the bride of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Please help us that we should be careful of what we say. Because, dear God, the bride has to be addressed in a right and respective manner.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ, may the great Holy Spirit take the lead of this meeting.
Amen.
Father, if there be any sick among us, I pray for a healing.
Amen.
If there be any, oh God, any situation that your children doesn't know how to come out of it, I ask that thou will please lead them out, oh God. In the name of my Lord and my Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Amen. You may
be seated, saints of God.
Praise the Lord. I would like to speak about the kingdom mentality. Amen.
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 The Lord Jesus Christ, when he taught his disciples to pray, he said to them, let thy kingdom come. Let thy will be done.
Amen.
As it is in heaven. The kingdom mentality. We are living in the world where there are two kingdoms that are ruling.
Yes.
We've got the kingdom of darkness and we've got the kingdom of light. And we've got the followers of the kingdom of light and we've got the followers of the kingdom of darkness. Amen.
Amen.
So these kingdoms, they always go together and they are always contrary to each other. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
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 So the kingdom of God is a realm where God reigns supreme.
Yes.
And Jesus is the King.
Yes.
The King of kings and the Lord of lords.
Yes.
Now the Bible says, let the mind that was in Christ be also in you.
Amen.
Now what was the mind of Christ? What was Jesus always thinking about?
Yesu ba dula na kana
kai. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
At the age of 12 years.
Ani wa ya 12.
While others were playing games.
Ba ba mai tsakala di
tsalo. While others were jolling around.
Ba ba mai kitimela ga kontsa.
Jesus was found in the house of God.
Yesu ba dula ai mo ba ho mo re.
Why Jesus was so different?
Ke ka ba ga na ba sa tsone le ba ba ba.
Because the mind of Jesus.
Sa ro khopolo ya Jesu.
Was of the kingdom.
Yeah.
Praise the name of the
Amen.
Lord. And as the children of God, we must have the same mentality.
Yes.
The kingdom mentality.
Yes.
The mind that was in Christ.
Yes.
Philippians says, let it be in us.
Yes.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
In that message, hear him. Preach 1954. The prophet of God is saying, the mind of Christ is to be in the church.
Amen.
Amen. And the mind of God was in Christ. And how that the Spirit led Christ, so ought his Spirit lead the church. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So Jesus, our Lord, was our example. We need to follow him. We need to follow after his footsteps.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord. Now, at the age of 12, I've already said that he did not have time to play. No time for nonsense. No time to play around and waste time with things that are worthless. His mind was focused on the kingdom.
Amen.
Now, he's saying the mind that was in Christ must be in the church. Unfortunately, the church is fast asleep. I'm here tonight to try to remind you that we are not of this world. We are just passing by. No matter what we can achieve, we're going to leave everything behind. As I speak right now, somebody is dying without God. The church is there doing nothing. The church is in a backsliding condition. Church, we need to wake up.
Amen.
Amen. What was Jesus doing in the temple? Jesus was busy with the doctors of divinity. Men who learned the Torah. Men who knew the law. They were called the doctors. But they were in darkness.
Amen.
Highly educated, but yet in darkness. Now Jesus at the age of 12, he was bold enough to sit down with these doctors. Remember, Jesus has never been to any school. Not a single day. But I'm not saying to you young people, you mustn't go to school. Amen.
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 You must go to school.
Amen.
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 Because if you don't go to school, you're going to be heavy upon the church.
Yeah.
The church must take care of you.
Yeah.
No, we don't want that. We want you to take care of the church.
Yeah.
Amen. So Jesus was trying to pull these men out of darkness into the light of God. That was the mentality that was in Jesus. Praise the name. Remember the Bible says in the book of Job, a man that is born of a woman is of few days. And his days are full of trouble.
Amen.
Amen. You know, when a child is born, after a week or so, that child must go to the clinic. The child has started a journey now. After a few months, that child, She's queuing in Sasa. For the grant. Not even a year old. Because the person that is born of a woman is of few days and full of trouble. And these troubles doesn't wait for this child to grow. The moment this baby is born, she must go to this place. She must be taken to the administration. Hey, go to the Department of Home Affairs. The baby is queuing. Queuing there by Sasa. Queuing at the clinics. Because this child has been born by a woman. And this child's life is of few days.
Amen.
You know what? There's no life here. I look this side, I look the other side. There's no hope. There's nothing left. It's like we are forcing ourselves to be here. But there is no hope.
Amen.
So our minds should be off from the things of the world. Now in the message, witnesses, the prophet of God says, you can't have the mind of Christ and the mind of the world at the same time. Meaning that you cannot serve two kingdoms. It's either you are in the kingdom of God or you are in the kingdom of darkness. And God is so just, He doesn't force you to be in either of the kingdoms. He gave each and every one of us a choice. You have a choice. And if you are in the kingdom of light, then walk in the light. Don't compromise the light. Stay 100% in the light. And don't mix the light with darkness, because they cannot come together. If you are a Christian, be a Christian. Amen. If you are a believer, be a believer. And if you are an unbeliever, be an unbeliever. Don't come to church and waste your time. Waste your time with other things there on the darkness. Because if you don't take the word of God, you're just wasting your time. And I'm here to tell you, please don't waste your time.
Amen.
If you still doubt this message, leave this message. And go leave your world in the world.
Amen.
And die and go to hell.
Amen.
Or take the light. Live for God.
Yeah.
Prepare yourself for the rapture. Yeah. Through the message of the hour.
Yeah.
And go in the rapture.
Yeah.
You know, God has got problem with us. God has got problems with us. When we are in certain conditions, we are Christians. And when we are in certain conditions, then we are not Christians. But Joshua said, make up your mind. If God be God, then let us serve God. And if Baal be God, then let us serve Baal. Because we cannot mix the two. It's oil and water. Don't come together. You cannot be in your way and God's way at the same time. You have to get out of your own way to let God have His way. That's the only way you are ever going to do anything. You got to get away from your own thoughts and your own reasons. Don't try to reason.
Yes.
Just believe.
Yeah.
Many times we don't see things, we reason them.
Yeah.
And we want to understand them.
Yeah.
But we are not called to reason.
Yeah.
We are called to believe.
Yeah. Amen. Amen.
Abraham did not waste his time by trying to reason that I'm an old man. How on earth will I be the father of many nations? No, no, no. He just believed. He just believed.
Who knows me?
And that was enough.
Yeah.
And God, through his belief, he tried him. And
Abraham,
he stood his ground. Whether I die or not, I will believe. Because he was convinced and concerned that his God was able to fulfill all his
promises.
Amen.
If he's done it for Abraham,
he
can do it for you.
Yeah.
But if your faith is wavering, you know a wave. Yes. You go to them and you've got waves. It goes up, it goes down. When things are okay, then it's up. When things are tough, it goes down. God doesn't want it that way. It should be consistent.
Amen.
Keep on believing. Through thick and thin. Keep the faith. Now
Mary
found this man, this boy rather, being busy about his father's business. He did not worry so much about other things. He did not even care that they left him behind. What was important to him was about to be in his father's business.
Amen.
Amen. Other things were not important to Jesus. But what was important to Jesus was to be about the father's business. Now Mary said to Jesus, your father and I,
she
forgot
that
she told the elders that the Holy Spirit and the angel told me that I will conceive. Now, 12 years later, she's turning around and claiming Joseph to be the father of Jesus. But Jesus is the Word, and the Word always corrects the error. Jesus said, don't you know that I must be about my father's business?
Yeah.
Now those elders were looking and listening.
Amen.
Because now if Joseph is his father, and Jesus must be about his father's business, and Joseph was a carpenter,
yeah.
So it means Jesus was supposed to be busy making tables. He was supposed to be busy making pulpits and chairs. But Jesus, his father, was God. That is why he was in his father's business. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. So that was the mentality of Jesus, to be about the father's business. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. The word always corrects the error. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Something I need here. Where the prophet was talking.
Amen.
Okay, the prophet was trying to explain to us
what
is the father's business.
So,
in other words, Jesus was a businessman.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
And he started this business at a very early age. Take your pen. Please write it down.
1959.
When the prophet is giving us an answer of what is the father's business. And please don't forget it. Because this is very important. He says, as Jesus said, Jesus said, wist ye not that I should be about my father's business? Question mark.
Utiso.
Now, what is the father's business? And his business is saving lost souls. Praise the name of the
Amen.
Lord. That is the business of the father. Now, Jesus turns around and he says, what will it profit? Remember, he's a businessman. In business, you talk about profit and losses. Now Jesus is asking a question. What will it profit? Amen. If he gains the whole world and lose his own soul,
Amen.
What will it profit us to gain the things of this world and at the end of the day lose our soul? Praise the name of the Lord. Father's business. Many times, the devil likes to be worshipped. Hence, we have devil worshippers. Men and women, boys and girls, who are worshipping the devil. Many, many people who are in the entertainment industry, they sold their souls to the devil. In exchange to luxury. Remember in Matthew 4, he took the Lord Jesus Christ to the high mountain and showed him the kingdom of the world. And he said to him, if you can only bow, I will give you all this kingdom. You see? Amen.
Amen.
Now, the love of the things of the world is a problem. Many have sold their souls because of the luxury of the things of the world. But Jesus refused to bow. And I'm saying to you, child of God, do not bow. You will get opportunity. Young sister, you'll get opportunities that maybe you can be a movie star and just put a short dress for this movie, and then we'll give you $1 million. Amen. But Jesus refused.
Amen.
Jesus refused to compromise. And child of God, do not compromise. Opportunities are there, but refuse them. Yes, our Lord Jesus refused them. Because his mind was for the kingdom. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Let me tell you something about your soul. Your soul, according to the prophet, he says it's worth 10,000. 10,000 worlds. That is the value of your soul. That is why the devil is after your soul. The devil wants your soul. It doesn't matter to him to give you everything you want, as long as he can have your soul.
Amen.
He's not so much worried about your body. Because your body around 1954-55 was around 86 cents worth.
In Africa, we have 86 cents.
Yeah. Way back. But now, your body now, I think it's around 3 cents.
Yeah. 2.5 cents.
So there's no value in your body. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So you cannot even boast of your body. Hence, Jesus did not care so much about this body. The Bible says he had only one garment. Only one. So you are blessed to have an old robe full of shirts and
clothes.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the name of God. It is not wrong to have those things. No. I'm just trying to show you the value of your body.
Amen.
It's valueless, so to speak.
Amen.
Amen. And we take so much care about the body. And sometimes we don't take enough care of this soul. The proof is that you can see this
church.
The people who are supposed to be sitting
here,
they don't care about their souls.
Amen.
Because if they were caring, they would be full in the this place would be full to capacity.
Yeah.
Even outside with packed chairs outside.
Yeah.
But the devil has stolen the revelation.
Amen.
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 When it's cold, they don't want to go to church. But they forget that this body will be in a mortuary someday.
Yeah.
In a freezer.
Amen.
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 So, beloved friends, let's take care of our souls.
Amen.
There are many teachings out there today which are deceiving.
Yes.
Many doctrines of men.
Amen.
Amen.
Run away.
Amen.
Run away.
Amen.
Get into God's business.
Amen.
Get into the kingdom mentality.
Amen.
Glory be to God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Let's read.
Arbali.
The message, the Lamb's Book of Life.
Now,
in 100 years from today, I don't know how many will be here.
I just about that. I'm going to
100 years from today.
I'm 100 from my mother.
I am 42 years.
So 100 years
time, I'll be 142.
I'm 100 years.
Which means I won't be here.
Well, that's the middle one.
So I don't think any of us will be here.
I don't know who will to wear that. I'm going to
all right. So, brethren, it would take a miracle of God if we're still living 100 years from today. Now, would be in eternity. What good would the $1 million do? Or all the feedings of the poor? And the things that we done, see, it wouldn't amount to very much. If I had a billion this morning, what good would it do to us after we are gone?
$1 billion.
Hey, just listen to the man of God. But let me tell you something. We haven't got that money. You are a poor man. All of us are. That's right. We live by the arms of the people. Being ministers. But brother, in Africa, one little boy, about this height, I don't know which height that is. About this height, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
One soul saved in eternity. When that star is shining, when it's shining yonder, our names will be wrapped into it. He said, there's your value. There's your value. It isn't how much you got, how much you desire. It's how much you can do towards saving souls.
Your
Christ Jesus. Our money will fade.
Amen.
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 It's how much you can do towards saving souls for Christ. What is the prophet saying here?
Yeah.
Whatever we can achieve, whatever money we can achieve, when we die, it's going to mean nothing.
Yeah.
Because it's got no value.
Praise
the name of the Lord.
Amen.
But that saving of a soul for Jesus Christ is what will have value.
He says,
I polish that little old fort. And this morning, sitting up there in the garage is a Cadillac. That they gave me. But one of these days, that Cadillac will be like the Ford.
It
will be no more. But God will still be the same. But if I get a soul saved for Christ, brother, as long as there's an eternity, the glory of God will rest on that soul. The only one soul.
Amen.
Christ Jesus. Now the prophet has got the kingdom mentality. He's showing us what is important.
Yeah.
He got the revelation of the kingdom.
Yeah.
That whatever we can achieve here, we're going to leave everything behind.
Yeah.
But that soul that we can bring into Christ will be identified with you throughout eternity.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So what is value? What is value anyhow? What good does it do? When the struggle is in your throat and the doctor sees the pulse coming up to your sleeves, what good is all the money and all the popularity? People to pat you on the back, or you become a great person, what good does that do to you? Not a bit. It vanishes.
And
stays here on the earth. But one soul saved, you see your name wrapped into it. As long as the morning star shall glitter in the sky.
Amen.
Amen. So let's save souls. Let's save souls. Praise the name of God.
Amen.
You say, I'm a sister, I cannot preach. But that long skirt is doing the preaching. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Glory be to God. He says, each one of you. He says, you housewives, you don't have to be a preacher. You do something for the glory of God. He
says,
speak to that boy that is delivering milk. Speak to those guys that are removing garbage. Call your neighbor. Sit down with your neighbor. Tell him about the goodness of Jesus. Tell her about the sweetness of Jesus Christ. And bring that soul into the kingdom. I'm not saying into the church. I'm saying into the kingdom. The kingdom. That is what is important. You are not serving churches. We are serving the kingdom. As you walk with God. Don't walk with a man. Don't walk with a friend. Your friend will disappoint you. But when you walk with God, you will definitely make it for eternity. Praise the name of God. Walk with God all the way. One day we will preach about walking with God. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord. Glory to God.
Amen.
Right.
Amen.
Yeah. I'm finishing up with this quotation in the message.
It's
a blushing prophet.
A blushing prophet.
Amen.
Amen.
Believers, we must believe this message.
Amen.
Brother Branham is saying this message is very urgent. The message is very urgent.
Amen.
He says we must stop arguing
about
theology.
Yeah.
Whether you are from this message church or from that message church, he said we should stop there.
Yes.
Because people are are dying in sin, we should be taking the message to the world. Now the devil has come with doctrine that we should argue about this doctrine. And while we are arguing about this doctrine, souls are perishing with this doctrine.
Hallelujah.
There's nothing that makes the devil happy than a soul dying without God. While believers are arguing in their churches, in their message lodges.
Amen.
Amen. These are lodges. The prophet has taught us that there's one church. And that church is the church of Jesus Christ. Those individuals. He says the rest is lodges. Even Branham Tabernacle is a lodge. But those believers in there, 1, 2, 3, which are part of the body, that is the church of Jesus. So we're wasting our time arguing about our churches. Our pastor is better than the pastor. We're wasting time. Souls are dying. Let's go after the souls and bring them into the kingdom. Amen.
Amen.
Jesus did not do a lot of things. He was not interested even in churches. When Jesus goes out, he was going after a soul. Whether he was hungry, when he got to Samaria, there was this infirm woman.
Amen.
Jesus speaks to her, gives her the gospel, and the woman, she runs and says, come here. There's a man here. Is this the Messiah? And when the disciples comes with food, he said, I don't want food anymore. I am food. Because I've done something for the kingdom. There's a soul that comes, came in, into the kingdom. Brethren, our mentality has to change. We have to change. Whether you belong to which church or that is not important. The thing is one, souls are dying without God. Since this service started, I don't know how many souls died. Without God. And that is not good. That is not good. That is not good. That has to be changed. Now Philippians says, let the mind. So it starts here. The mind of Christ. Then if we have the mind of Christ, then we will do the works of Christ. And the works of Christ is to go after the lost souls and pull them out of the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of light.
Amen.
Let me tell you, the rapture is delayed by the bride. Some of the members of the body of Christ are still in the world. The deacons in taverns. The deacons' wives in taverns. We've got preachers in taverns. But they must be called. Somebody has to stand up and preach the gospel right in the tavern. And preach repentance in the tavern. And pull them out.
Hallelujah.
John the Baptist was not afraid. He was not afraid that he would preach marriage and divorce right in the parliament.
Amen.
The deacons tried to stop him, but he was unstoppable. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So Jesus is normal.
Amen.
But the Holy Spirit is here.
Amen.
Amen. And the Spirit that was anointing Christ must anoint the church.
Amen.
Then the church will do the works of Christ.
Amen.
That is how it goes.
Yeah.
So we will be like tending in the wilderness. Like
the wilderness.
Because of some souls That must come in.
Yes,
which we don't testify to.
Yes, I
and the more we waste time, we will die.
We go, Valerie.
And the young men, they will grow up, and get married, and preach the same gospel, and it will be like a
tent.
Because souls that are supposed to be in are still there. Some of those souls are Sangomas. God loves that Sangoma. She's a daughter of God. But she's in darkness.
Amen.
Somebody has to stand up and free her.
Amen.
Beloved, I've taken too much time. May I stop here? May God bless you. As we let the mind that was in Christ be in us
too.
I'm so sorry I have to stop here. And may God bless you.
Yes,
you bow.
Amen. Hey. Yeah.
Hey. Maybe you are fearful. Maybe you don't have the courage to do it. The prophet of God says, if you cannot go out and reach out, then support the missionary. Help somebody that can go out.
Amen.
Amen. And let that man preach the gospel around there. We don't have any excuse not to do it. The Jehovah Witnesses are challenging me too much. Wherever I go, they are there.
Yeah.
In the morning, I go to the hospital, they are already there with their books. I try to look for the message believers. Something is not right. We need a change. We need a transformation of our minds.
Amen.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, dear God, here are your children. I believe that they are part of the body of Christ.
Amen.
I believe that they are part of the bride.
Amen.
My God, as little as they are in this place, I pray for a special revelation. Dear God, I pray for a special understanding.
Amen.
Mighty Jehovah, I pray, dear God, that thou will please enter their hearts,
Amen.
Enter their minds. And may you please, Lord, don't let them rest day and night.
Amen.
May the mind that was in Christ Jesus be in them, Father.
Amen.
May you help them, dear God, to reach out like never before.
Amen.
Father God, young sisters, young brothers, old papas, dear God, every one of us.
Amen.
May you grant us the grace to reach out, O God, and preach this gospel of Jesus Christ. If we cannot testify, Lord God, help us to sing on the street corners.
Amen.
Dear God, help us that we should do something towards your kingdom, my Lord. In the name of my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, Father, I thank you. And I pray a special blessing upon these brothers and sisters.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, may you bless them. I believe that their coming in here was not in vain, O God. May you bless them richly and abundantly. This I ask, my dear Father, in the name of my Lord and my Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
May the good Lord bless you.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen.